I'm Georgia Groome, and I'm performing in Clickbait by Millie Thomas at Theatre 503. Clickbait's the story of a teenage girl called Nicola, who goes on holiday and is filmed in a nightclub performing sexual acts. She comes home to England, and the video, she's being blackmailed with the video. They're saying they're going to leak it unless she provides money, and it's the story of her turning that exploitation into a good thing for her. So she posts the video herself, and then it unwinds from there. So I play Nicola, who is the girl who's being blackmailed with the sex tape, and it's a really interesting journey she makes. It's not necessarily obvious, or all the choices I would have made. But she finds kind of empowerment through her actions, and then goes on a very rocky road to the end of the play. But it's just a really different part. It's hard. She's quite boisterous and hardline, and I'm really not. So I really was looking forward to the challenge of playing her. Miley Cyrus has been a really big inspiration, kind of the new Miley, as opposed to her Hannah Montana days of innocence, and just her kind of using her sexuality and essentially exploiting herself in a really positive way has caused such a stir that it was really helpful. We watched a lot of her videos and a lot of her quotes. I think she said something like, you can try and hack my computer and find naked photos, I'm just gonna post them myself. Like, go for it, I'll just post them. Which she said kind of mid-rehearsals, and that was really exciting for everyone because it kind of based what we were doing in a really strong way. Millie Thomas has written the play, and she's fantastic. She has a really strong voice that comes through in her writing. It's very snappy, and she really kind of knows the issues and has had fun with the issues in creating the play. And then directing is Holly Race Rolden, who's just brilliant as well. And they're kind of a great team. And it's been really fun to work with so many women. We have one male cast member, and we had a male assistant director. And it was nice to have a male presence, but you never get to work on like such a female-heavy team in theatre or film. So that was really exciting. And they were kind of a dream collaboration, I guess, which has been good. Nicola has two sisters, an older sister called Gina, and a younger sister called Chloe, and how they deal with the kind of video being released and onwards is very different. Kind of Gina's character is quite uptight, and she feels the worry and the fear and the social consequences before being pulled along for the ride. And whereas Chloe is a bit younger and is really kind of social media savvy, so it's her that really fuels the play forwards in terms of getting the video out and kind of trending. And then we have my boyfriend, who struggles the whole way through with kind of understanding Nicola's choices, I think, as you probably would. And I think we drew inspiration for him from, there's a documentary called Hot Girls Wanted on Netflix, which explores webcamming and kind of the young girls. I think it's in Miami or Vegas. And there's a boyfriend in that whose girlfriend is webcamming, and he just finds it extraordinarily difficult, but is still with her. And then we have the bloggers make up the kind of majority of the play, really. They're the outside voice. They're played by the rest of the cast in fox masks, bear masks. And they're kind of giving the tweets and the comments that would be made by keyboard warriors on the internet. And then we have Kat, who is a client of the business we set up. And I can't say much more about her because it's spoilers. Our production designer, Frankie, has created this kind of mad world. Everything's white, a bit like, it's a bit of an iPhone. The set looks like an iPhone. And the sound design and the lights as well kind of bring that world to life. It's all kind of like the swipes of your finger on the iPhone and the noises tweets make the whole way through, kind of the laptop and the phone and things like that have a really kind of strong role within the play, because it's all to do with online and that thing of once it's out there, you can't take it back, which is so topical right now. And so everything's kind of crispy and white with splashes of colour. And that's kind of the world that's been created. I think what I'm hoping, I think what we all hoped would happen has happened. And that's that people go out talking about the issues. I had a load of my closest friends in last night who all kind of came out being like, but what would you do? And like, what would you, how would you react if that was your sister? Da, 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 da. But also the wider kind of topics of consent and the empowerment and claiming back our sexuality and things like that. I think a lot of plays tie things up into a neat bow of that's what I think. And I think you don't get that with Clickbait. I think it leaves, there's not a clear viewpoint. It kind of touches on everything, which is so brilliant. Cause it lets the audience think for themselves rather than telling the audience that, you know, porn is good or porn is bad and, you know, women are sexual creatures, women aren't. You can leave and make your own mind up, but equally kind of, I think it makes you look at your kind of morals in quite a clear way. And that's really exciting. I think it's exciting to leave the theatre. I like to leave the theatre and think and kind of go away, buzzing off the plane, thinking about it. And that's what the audience seems to have been doing, especially the young people. Like, they've really got it and have taken a lot away from it, as far as we know.